Both teams have sent their special teams onto the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. And down he goes at the 31. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. He's taken down at the 40. Fights forward to about the 40. Illinois's got a guy that statistically is leading the conference right now, and he has got the attention of everybody in the country, including the coordinator. And he's tackled right around the 44-yard line.
This is a big first down for this offense. I think it's another good example about how important it is to have an awareness about you as a wide receiver. Wide receiver does job of knowing exactly where the first down marker was, and he made sure to get the route at least to that point, so when he made the catch and got hit, he had the first down pass.
Bennett, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it
second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 44. Tackle made at about the 43-yard line. Nowhere to go for the halfback. That's a loss of one. He goes downtown. Got it to the senior. They'll bring him down at about the 15-yard line.
That was more than enough to pick up the first down. Next time, this defense will be playing on their heels.
Makes it out to about the 7. Hits the PAT. An 8-play, 69-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Illinois is ready to kick it away. Taken from the 3-yard line. Tackle at the 25. The Falcons, in talking with them this week, Kirk, is just interesting. Their perspective on this kid, how good he is, and how much they can lean on him.
Yeah, you and I had a chance to visit with not only the coaches, but the player himself, and I got a real good vibe walking out of those meetings and thinking that he's going to have a huge game. The coaches seem confident in being able to get him the football in different areas on the field. This kid has a look in his eye that I haven't seen yet.
The ball is loose. Looks like the offense has it. And the booth is going to take a few looks at this to see whether or not the ball came out before he was down. They're going to review this fumble, and I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this call.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So after review, they decide that this call should be reversed. From their own 22-yard line. It's second down. Brought down at the 19-yard line.
He knew it was a run all the way. Got a good jump. Once he got there, he wasn't about to let him slip away either.
Thank you. quick strike, and he drops it.
Boy, that hurts the offense to have to go three and out. They're going to have to think about how to get something going the next time they come out.
They're stacking the line. It looks like they're coming after this punt. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. Well, they got the result you always want on the last drive. Let's see if it happens again.
And it was a really nice drive, too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
He's tackled at the 30. Illinois is up a score. Off up the middle, and down he goes right around the 28-yard line, and the short gain is enough for the first.
And that tailback definitely has a nose for that first down marker.
He's at the 20, and they make the stop at about the 13.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down. Take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Inside and tackled quickly. Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. Tackled around the 13-yard line. So they get a few on the pass play, but they're still way short of that first down marker.
When you have third down and a mile, sometimes it's just better to go underneath and pick up a few yards rather than risking an interception downfield.
Kicks away, and he got it. Brown gets set to kick this one away. Taken at the 5. Brought down at the 31-yard line. Illinois' defense is playing lights out right now and pitching a shutout.
Yeah, I would not be shocked at all to see this defense be able to maintain this. Just the way they're playing, the attitude that they seem to be playing with, if they can maintain the energy and the awareness of this offense, there's a very good shot that they could shut this offense out.
It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one. King, the ball carrier. He's knocked out of bounds. It's right around the 46-yard line.
Very well-designed play that time to give him a first down. The linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good gain.
From their own 46-yard line, first down. And he's taken down at the 49. Pitch looking for the corner. Makes it out to about the 40. As we change into the field, I don't think we're going to be seeing much of a change in the outcome. 10-0, Fighting Illini. And we're back for more action here in quarter number 2. He's at the 30. He makes his way to about the 22.
That makes it first and 10.
From the 22-yard line, first down. Makes it out to about the 10.
That's good game, 12 yards. First down.
Gets to about the 8-yard line. From the 8-yard line, second down. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
That'll bring up third and two.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. And they'll bring in the goal line set for this one. Slings it out, and it gets tipped. So they're going to go for it here. They'll run for it. Can't get there. Not quite enough for the first. Looks like they'll turn it over on downs.
You know what? I think they still made the right call there.
Really a great stop by the defense. This will go down as one of those critical plays. You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Throws complete, and he's hit right away. Him hard at the 19. And a quick throw. He's taken down at the 26. Yard line. He fights forward to about the 36. Nothing there on the keeper. About 4 yards away here on third down.
Hey, defense, let's go. Mike 55, Mike 55. Hey, eat. Go.
Screen pass. He's got his halfback. He steps out at about the 39-yard line.
That makes it fourth and inches.
McNeil is. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. Right now, this game's got all the makings of maybe being a nail-biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, probably into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime.
Patrick was the intended receiver on the play.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 36. Tries to fit it in there, but it's picked off.
That's the last thing they needed to happen was an interception. They're trying to fight to get back into this game, and to have that miscue, now it's really up to their defense to try to help them out.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. Straight ahead on the give, and there's nowhere to run.
That was just a case of one lineman dominating another and making the play.
Out of bounds, right around the 38-yard line. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. He's at the 30, gains his way to the 23-yard line. It to the left. Almost picked off.
Boy, Brad, this guy drops an interception, and what's ironic about that, going to the meetings the other day, is that this guy's been telling the coaches he wants to play some wide receiver. You wonder why you're not playing wide receiver? Because you can't catch the ball as a defensive back.
Quick strike to the receiver. Tackle made at about the 19-yard line.
That'll bring up third and six.
A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
This guy is one of the most reliable receivers around. They needed a big play on third down, and he got it for them.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. He's hit and taken down. Wide receivers. And he's level at the 2 yard line. And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive lineman have after that.
So it's fourth down. They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than that. It's up, and it sails through the uprights. It's been a well-fought game as we head to the half. 13 to nothing, Illinois.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. These teams only play one game a week, only 12 games in a normal regular season. I think fans have a hard time understanding why their squad can come out and play without any energy, any emotion. Keep it real with us. Tell us what it's like. Why is it hard for a player sometimes in a game like this?
What? If the fans showed the same emotion, then maybe we would too as a player. Because think about it. When I walk out there and I'm playing one of the big dogs, the stadium's rocking. They're going crazy. They're going ballistic. They're hydrated. You know exactly what's going on. They're into it. They've been tailgating for hours. Well, there's a reason these little games, they don't get up for us. They don't get as excited. They're not yelling and screaming as much. It's like you turn the volume down at home. I mean, you can hear the difference. I know the difference. I know I'm supposed to beat this opponent. It's really a matter of just by how much I'm supposed to win by. So there is a difference. You can feel it in the fans, and you can feel it sometimes as a player.
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. Chase from the 7. They'll bring him down at the 29-yard line. Illinois is the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers, the way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage. I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. He gets hit out of bounds around the 41-yard line.
It's great when a running attack comes through for the first down like this. It makes an offense so much more versatile.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 41. Gets to about the 44-yard line. And he takes it hard at the 41-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 49. Wants it all, going long. They'll bring him down at about the 29-yard line. First down.
Scrambling around.
They bring the quarterback down. Johnson's every bit as good as his clipping suggests. That's his first sack of his career. The coaches say he's got it all. Swim moves, spins, bull rush, whatever it takes to get to the quarterback. It's second and 11. Ball on the 30-yard line. He's at the 20. Inside the 10. Touchdown, Falcons. He makes the PAT. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. Gets out to about the 21. It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? Illinois with a 6-point lead.
Hey, kill, kill, kill.
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And down he goes at the 27. Middle for a nice run. he's hit before it can go anywhere. Not a bad little play there.
Yeah, this is a nice job by the quarterback reading the coverage and delivering a very catchable ball and allowing his receiver to come up with a nice game.
Up the middle for a nice game. To his receiver, and they make the stop at the 44. Gets out to around the 35.
That's a deep man. That brings up second and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one.
Roger, Roger.
Hey, Illinois up six.
Red two.
On the pitch, look out, loose ball. So the offense turns over the pigskin.
The ball carrier here was just careless in handling the ball, and a great awareness by the defense to jump on it.
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Runs left and quickly taken down. Second and 10. Ball on the 37-yard line. He's at midfield. He's pushed out of bounds around the 44-yard line. He fights forward to about the 43. From the 43-yard line, second down. Brought down right around the 30.
That's good for a gain of 13 yards. First down.
From the 26-yard line, second down. Nice run, and he's brought down. So at the end of three, the Fighting Illini lead 13-7. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. There's a very impressive open field tackle.
They're eating up a lot of field on this drive. I'm really impressed with their ball control.
From the 12-yard line, it's first down. The offense needs something new down here in the red zone. Around the 1 yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Touchdown! Tie ball game. What a target. That tight end is close to the goal line.
Well, the coach has to be happy with this guy's play so far, so I would expect to see a lot of passes thrown his way, especially in short yardage situations.
Trying to take the lead. Here's the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. A 9-play, 63-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. It can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
He's tackled at the 23. Things aren't tied, but they might as well be. It's this drive that could really dictate the tone for the last quarter. Quick throw. This is going to be a first down, and he's taken down at the 37. Would have been a big play by the defense. He can't hold it.
You like a team that's ready to defend the pass. It takes some preparation to get in the way of a pass like that.
From their own 37-yard line, it's second down. And he throws it away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
With the pass, incomplete. Larson is the deep man awaiting the return. And down he goes at the 32. A score here might effectively end this one. Air Force up a point. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. He's finally tackled at the 31. That makes it first and 10. So it's first and 10 after the big run. Tackled at the 33.
This defensive end just showed us why he's much more than just a pass rusher.
He's at the 20, inside the 10. He's all the way home, touchdown. What a play by the fullback there.
For a fullback, this guy runs exceptionally well. I mean, he's running right by linebackers with 4.7 speed out there. That is not something we see very often from fullbacks at the college level.
And he adds the extra point. A short 3-play, 68-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, not only did they put points on the board, but I think it's the way they did it. That could be demoralizing for defense.
So our score, 21-13. Murphy fields it at the 11. Brought down at the 27-yard line. You You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Just under three to go in regulation. Nice play across the middle. He's taken down at the 46. Probably should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a blanket around that receiver. Somebody else had to be open.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 38.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on him.
So the sack makes this third and very long.
Red 2, X, 7.
Motion.
Go!
Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He's tackled at the 50. Passes to the right, it's picked off. And this could be a big return. He's at the 40, to the 10. Touchdown, Air Force. With that score, now it's up to the defense, and they're well aware that maybe one stop and they've got a victory. So the officials are going to take a look at some of the replay angles.
And what they're looking for is whether or not the ball touched the ground before he had possession.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So they review it, but there's just not enough evidence to overturn this one. Just over a minute left. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Reese Davis joins us in the studio with this update. Reese?
The Demon Deacons came into the game ranked ninth after the bitterly disappointing loss. How far will the pollsters move them down? And for Wake Forest, they've dropped two straight. The Broncos win it by 19.
Well, that's an absolutely shocking upset. You can count on that one to turn the polls upside down when they're released. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. From the 5-yard line, he's out to the 30. And he's tackled at the 36. It's going to be interesting now to see if this quarterback can put that last throw behind him.
This quarterback needs to be a little bit more careful because this defense is excellent on capitalizing off of mistakes.
And he's immediately tackled.
Hey, kill, kill, kill! Where?
He's hit and taken down. The 14.
He had a couple of freight trains coming at him, but when they blitzed, it created a hole in the coverage. And he took advantage of it.
Quick out to his receiver. Touchdown, Fighting Illini. So the offense will stay on the field and attempt the two-point conversion. Under a minute left. He's got it for two. So with less than a minute to go in the fourth quarter, the score is 28-21, Airport. They'll bring him down at the 41-yard line. The Falcons are on a roll right now, an absolute roll. 21 straight points, and the defense has no answer for them. The whistle hasn't sounded yet. They still have to snap the ball and make sure they don't make any mistakes. They'll bring him down right around the 46-yard line.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
It's second down, 15 to go. Ball on the 46. Here's the give. He's at the 30, the 10, and he scores. Touchdown. Patterson's play showing why he's a humble kid, and I'm sure he's going to give the credit to his offensive line.
Yeah, Brad, nothing is more gratifying to me watching a game like this unfold than a superstar player like this going straight to his offensive lineman and giving them the credit for that touchdown. What a class act.
And he hits the PAT. A short two-play, 41-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Murphy fields it at the 11. The 50. He finally goes down at the 30-yard line. And as the defense comes back out, you can be sure they're thinking about that score they surrendered the last time around.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against his defense.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Under a minute left in the game.
Blue 20, go!
Deep ball, laying it out there. Quick throw out to the receiver. And he converts the extra point. A four-play, 30-yard drive, and they get it in for seven. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. He takes the knee, looking to take some time off that clock. Illinois called their final timeout. You're an offensive coordinator, you love this play. His quarterback will take a knee. We had a fight to the finish here today. Air Force 35, Illinois 28. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.